Hey guys, my name is That Quiet Kid, and today we're going to do week 3 assignment of NPTEL Ethical Hacking course. So the first question is, which of the following is are true for direct packet delivery option in a routing table? So basically there are two packet delivery options. First is direct and second is indirect. If you are talking about sending a packet inside a network, that is, you know, to a host or to a router inside a network, then it is direct packet delivery option is used. And if we have to send the packet outside the network in which two or more routers are involved, then it is indirect. So in this, according to this question, based on the destination IP address, the packet is forwarded to the destination host present in the same network. This will be the C part, will be the option of the first question. Second is, which of the following host address represents the default route in a routing table? So the default route is 0.0.0.0. So the answer will be none of these. And next, third question we have, what does the value 1 in the G flag of a routing table signify? So basically G represents a gateway. If the G flag is set to 0, then it means that the destination is in the same network, that we don't need to go through a gateway or a router to go we don't need to go through a gateway in order to go to the outside network. That is, our destination is in the current network. But if the value is set to 1, it means it involves a gateway or a hop in order to reach its destination. So the destination is in a different network when the G flag is equals to 1. So C will be the option. None of these for second. And fourth is, which of the following statement is are true for interior routing protocol? So two routing protocols. First is interior and second is exterior. So when, as the name suggests, if it is interior, it means it's in the same network. So basically all the options will be A and D, which is all the participating routers are present in the same autonomous system. Autonomous system is like the system is controlled by one body, that is, it's inside the same network, and routers in the same autonomous system exchange messages to update their routing tables. So these are the statements which will be true for interior routing protocol. Fifth is, if a packet is to be delivered to exactly one within a given set of hosts in a network, what kind of address should we use to specify the destination? So if the packet was to be delivered to a particular host only, so I think that in that case the answer should be unicast. But here it tells us that we have a given set of hosts, so we have a choice here, and we are still after given the choice we are selecting one. So the answer will be anycast address. And question 6 is, what is the destination network address, how is the destination network address determined while finding a match in the routing table? So when we are trying to find a match in the routing table, we perform a bitwise AND of the destination IP address with the subnet mask in the routing table. So through this, you can also answer the ninth question, which is, consider the following routing table in a router. On which interface will an IP packet with destination address as 161.44.64.120 will be forwarded? So as you can see that we have the subnet mask of we have five interfaces through which it can be transferred, but all we have to do is we have to perform the bitwise AND of this destination IP address with the subnet mask. And if the destination is equal to the destination present here, then this will be the interface that will be selected. I will show you when I will do the ninth question. So first, perform bitwise AND of the destination IP address of the packet with the subnet mask entry in the routing table. So seventh is, what are the links between neighbor routers? How are the links between neighbor routers kept alive in the OSPF protocol? So by periodically sending hello packets to keep the link alive. Which of the following represents tunneling? So basically tunneling happens when we have IPv6 packet, but the routers involved in sending the message only use IPv4 technology. So what happens is, we take a IPv4 as a header, and inside it we use this IPv6 packet as a payload. So an entire IPv6 packet is included as a payload inside an IPv4 packet, will be the answer to this 8th question, which is which of the following represents tunneling. So coming to 9th question, all we have to do is perform a bit by bit AND of this and this. So let me show you. We have 128, we have 64, we have 32, we have 16, we have 8, we have 4, we have 2, we have 1. Okay, so we have the destination IP address 161.44.64.120. So when we have 255.255.0.0, it means we have 16 bit. So this 161.44 will be the same. So now we have to check for is 64 and 120. So if we perform the bit AND of 0.0 and 64.120, the answer will be 0.0. How do I know this? Because the AND operation is actually saying if you have 1 and 1, then it is 1, and if you have 1 or 0 or 0 or 1, then it is 0 or 0 or 0, it is. So AND operation basically means if both are 1, then only we will consider it as 1, and otherwise we will consider it as 0. So when all the subnet mask is 0 and 0, then this will basically be 0 and 0. So this can be a answer. But what happens here is we have to check for other options as well. And if we do the bit by bit operation of this second interface, that is 255.255.224, what is 224 when it comes to in binary? So 224 is 1 here. Okay, let me go down. It's 1 and it's 1, and rest are 0. So this represents, okay, let me represent. So this represents 224 in a binary, and now we have this 64 is 64. So how does we represent 64? It's simply by all 0, only here 1, and rest are 0000. So basically we can say that AND operation is if both are 1, then we will consider it, and is the only the 64th option is 1. So the answer will be 161.44.64.0. So this will be this can be a route for sending the packet. So between these two, what we have to consider is it works by using this prefix method, that is which one has the longest prefix, it will be the route. So what I mean by prefix, as you can see that we have 255.255.255.255. So what we have here is 32 bit address. So if we cancel out the last digit, what we have now, we have 24 bit address. So what happens here, we have to check which of these following subnet mask has the longest prefix. So you can see clearly that this 255.255.224.0 has the longest prefix bit, so interface B will be the option. And if you want to perform the bit by bit operation of this and the other options, I will save you the time. You can see that we first have this 255.255, which means 161.44 are same, and then we have 255. So 64, the AND operation of 64 and 255 will be 64. So we have 68 options. So this cancels out this option, that is C option is also cancelled out, D option is also cancelled out, and last, which is default is when we cannot find a match. But we already found a match, we have found two matches, and we have chosen the B option because of the longest prefix. So the last three options are cancelled out, B is our option. We had two options for through which we can send our two interface options through which we can send our packet. We have chosen this B interface. So the last question is, an entry in a routing table has 155.86.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0 56.0 as the destination and subnet mask is 22. So what does this subnet mask 22 means? Which means it has 255.255. And for we know that it's total in 32. When we know it's 22, it means it has all, you know, all bits up to this 2 are 1. I'm trying to say it's 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and 1, and 0, and 0. So this is what the 6 bit means here. So the what I'm trying to say is it's just 2 bits less than the 255.255. It should be 252. Okay, so the answer will be, if we perform the bit by bit operation of this 56, let me show what 56 means in binary. So 56 will be represented by 0 0, it will be 1, it will be 1. 32 plus 16 is 48, and this 8 will be 56, and rest are 0. So you can see that this represents 56, and we have to perform this, you know, bit by bit. And so I already told you how we can do this. I have already done this, and if you perform this bit by bit and of these two, we will get this 56, so which is 155.86.56.0. so this will be the answer of the last question, and that completes our week 3 assignment. I hope I explained everything I could, and if you have any doubts, post it in the comment section and I will try to answer it. So thank you for watching.